शरदिन्दुविकासिमन्दहासां स्फुरदिन्दीवरलोचनाभिरामाम् अरविन्दसमानसुन्दरास्याम् अरविन्दासनसुन्दरीमुपासे। हरिः ओम्। In the last class, we have seen what the Ukaradesha Visarga Sandhi was. In today's class, we shall see what the Lopa, Visarga Lopa is. The Visarga Lopa is actually not a Sandhi per se, because a Sandhi is generally understood to be a change in the Varna, but some also classify Lopa being the fourth function of a Sandhi, if you remember. The sandhis can be four types, agama, adesha, prakriti bhava and lopa. Under such a definition, you can consider this visarga lopa to be also a sandhi. So I would like to call it the lopa sandhi. In this case, again, lopa comes under the first case. That is when the para is either a swara or a mridu vyanjana. In the first case, we have the lopa sandhi, and in the first scenario, of where the lopa should happen, we have the upadha being a. Now, why is this upadha column there? Again, remember, recollect that the first case, ukara desha, lopa, and the repha desha depend not only on the para but also the upadha. Hence, depending on what the upadha is, the lopa also changes. I mean, the cases where lopa happens also changes. So, the upadha in the first scenario is where the Dirgha Aakara is there. The Purva is again, as usual, the Visarga. The Para is, however, a Swara or a Mridu Vyanjanam. In that case, a Lopa happens. Lopa means vanishing. The Visarga elides. It vanishes. There is nothing substituted in place of the Visarga other than just a blank space. It is the Lopa. It leaves. Now, you see an example here, Balaha Atanti. So the Upadha is A. First of all, again, go back to the algorithm. The first step, it is a Visarga, so do the Visarga Sandhi. Second step, see what the Para is. The Para is a Swara. So you come to the first case. Okay, good. The first case has many, again, subdivisions. You see, then you go to the, what type of Para it is. It is a Swara, okay. What type of Swara is it? It is the Akara. Hraswa Akara. So now you have two or more divisions. So you can either go to the Ukara Desha, because here also you see that the Para was Akara in the second scenario. Is it not? So here again there's a confusion. So now which Sandhi should I do? Therefore, see, in the first case, always it depends on the para and upadha. Therefore, you just go to the upadha. You see what the upadha is. It is a. So, is there a case in the Ukara Desha where the upadha is a? Not at all. In both the scenarios, consists of only a. Therefore, you come back to the lopa. In the lopa, you say, okay, the upadha is a. The para is a swara. Okay. So, you make the visarga disappear. So you just remove it. You say bala atanti. That's it. And you remember that wherever a lopa happens, further sandhis are prohibited. So don't do any more sandhis of thinking, oh, you can do a plus a is dirgha sandhi, savarna dirgha sandhi. Do it. Kick in the, put some more sandhis. And she say bala atanti. No, that is wrong. You give that pause here. Bala atanti. That pause signifies that the visarga has elided, it has been destroyed, and that blank space is what has been substituted in the place of visarga. So this bala atanti, that's it. Similarly, you have janaha ghoshayanti. Again, you have the mridu vyanjana, visarga, come to the case one. Under case one, you see what type of the para it is. It is a vyanjana. Is it a mridu vyanjana? Yes, it is a mridu vyanjana. How is it a mridu vyanjana? Because it belongs to the fourth column. Ka, kha, ga, gha, the fourth one. So 3, 4, 5 are the mridu vyanjanas. Again, It should be in your fingertips what the mrudu vyanjanas and the karkasha vyanjanas are. Next, you see that does this satisfy this scenario? Is the upadha Yes, it is. So it, don't do the ukara desha, do the lopa. So remove the visarga, that's it. Jana ghoshayanti, that's it. Jana ghoshayanti. Why didn't you do the ukara desha? Because the upadha is see here, To do the upadha in the ukara desha, you should have been hraswa Is it so? In ukara desha, the hraswa was the upadha. Here, is the upadha. Therefore, you should do the lopa. Then, the second scenario is where you have the as the upadha. Wow, now this is more confusing. Then you have the visarga, and then in the para you have akaram vina anyaswaraha tadapi lopaha. The para akshara here now is aswara, but what type of swara is it? It is any swara but the hraswa akara. Akaram vina anyaswaraha. So it can be a, e, u, r, a, i, o, au. All of them form the possibilities at this point. Except the hraswa akara. Again, hraswa akara for emphasis. Therefore, you have the upadha being a, visarga, and any swara but the hraswa a. Now, why has this rule come? Because if it were the hraswa akara, then the lopa should not have happened. It would have become the ukara desha condition. Therefore, when the hraswa akara is present, when the upadha is a, you should do the ukara desha. But if you don't have the hraswa akara but any other swara, that's important, any other swara, it is not a vyanjana, any other swara alone, then you have the lopa again. For example, jayaha iti, jayaha aha, aha, then iti, e is the para. Is e the hraswa akara? No. So don't do the ukara desha, do the lopa. Just write it as jaya iti. So now what is important in visarga sandhi is to see which of the scenarios belonging to which case under which conditions apply at a given example, in a given example. That is very important. You have to go systematically so that you don't get confused in the beginning itself. You learn the first ukara, first you have learned the sakara desha, which is the case 2. Done. Now when you have come to case 1, you see the different subdivisions. Go step by step. So first you analyze the para. Then you analyze the upadha. And you see which condition is satisfied. Accordingly, you go to which subdivision is again to be applied. You see the upadha is a. See here, a. The para is e. That satisfies the condition of lopa. So destroy the, delete the visarga, it becomes jaya iti. Don't do any more sandhis here again. Don't say jayeti. That is different. That is the guna. But here, since this space has come because of the destruction, the nuclear bomb has been dropped on the visarga. So that place has become very radioactive. It has got vitrified. Therefore, no more sandhis are allowed here. Jaya iti. Now the third scenario is where, it is of the lopa itself, when the purva pada, the entire purva pada itself, it is not the purva akshara, listen carefully, it is the purva pada, the entire first word itself is the saha or the eshaha. Now these two are not any other usual saha or eshaha, it is the pronoun, the pullinga pronoun saha, he, eshaha, this person, that person, this person. In the masculine gender. Specifically, when these two, either of these two come as the purva pada, not the purva akshara again, purva pada, and in front of them, you can have any other letter which belongs to this case. What does that mean? Now see, we are dealing with the first case, correct? We are dealing ukara, desha, lopa, all of these belong to which case? They belong to the first case. This is the first case, correct? The first case is determined when the para is mrudu or the swara. Remember, it has mrudu swara. Therefore, when the para, the purva pada itself is saha or eshaha, and whatever be the para under this case, meaning whatever be the para, be it a mrudu vyanjana or any swara other than the hraswa akara, again, now that we shall discuss in the exception. So any other swara or vyanjana, you destroy the visarga. So it becomes sa agachati. Sa agachati. Did you understand? So saha or eshaha is the entire first word. And then the para is any vyanjana. Could be a mrudu vyanjana or a swara. Any swara or a mrudu, any vyanjana, which belongs to this case of, in this case, it is the mrudu vyanjanas. Now, the speciality is that this rule actually applies not only to the lopa, which is under the case 1, but also to the case 2, which is a karkasha vyanjana. To summarize, this saha or eshaha initially is written under the case 1, correct? Which means the para is a mrudu vyanjana or a swara. But this rule, this specific rule of saha or eshaha, actually applies to both the case 1 as well as case 2 equally. Therefore, you have saha and agachati as an example. Here I should demonstrate it and elaborate further. You have the saha, the entire purva pada is saha. Don't now bother about what the upadha is, etc. Now the entire pada itself is saha. It is not a part of some other word like manasaha, etc. It is the entire word itself is saha. Then you have the para being any other vyanjana or aswara. Then the visarga disappears. So it becomes sa agachati. Again, no more sandhis. Sa agachati. That instantaneous pause. Sa agachati. Sa agachati. Then you have another example, like for eshaha also the similar rule applies. So eshaha khidyate. Oh, now the para is a karkasha vyanjana. So does this rule apply? Yes, it does. This rule is actually a broader rule which applies equally to both the case 1 as well as case 2. So visarga has disappeared. It becomes esha khidyate. Esha khidyate. Okay. Now this exception that I was speaking of is here. We said in this rule, whatever be the para akshara, whatever it be it a swara or a vyanjana, any vyanjana, or be it any swara, you have to disappear the visarga. So it becomes sa agachati, sa iti, sa evam, sa oshadhihi, sa autsukyam, sa ranam, esha ranam, esha ira, esha adhyam, etc. Anything like that. And then again with any other vyanjan also. Esha naraha, esha manavaha, esha tsaruhu, etc. Now that rule applies to all vyanjanas and all swaras. So when you say all swaras, here comes an exception. It does not include the hraswa akara again. So now this akara is always the problematic swara. Now, this is very crucial in determining what type of sandhis occur. It always plays about the ukara desha, lopa, and again in lopa, and again in the repha desha also, it comes about. So now this akara, which is the hraswa akara, if it be the para akshara, then don't go as this rule says. It says to disappear, delete the visarga. Don't do that. Instead, you do the ukara desha is the exception. This exception rules that when the para is the hrasva akara, the purva pada being the saha or eshaha, then you do the ukara desha as usual. And if you remember the ukara desha, that S thing, that avagraha comes here. Soham, eshoyam, eshopi, just as the ukara desha was, had happened here. You see here, this O, krishnopi, eshopi, sopi, soham, eshoham, all of that. So now how is this an exception? Because this rule stated that the parakshara can be anything, anything. Be it a vyanjana or a swara, any kind of swara or any kind of vyanjana was this rule, the third scenario. But negating that statement of all swaras, you have one counter example here, that is the a. The counter case scenario here is the a. So when only this hrasva akara comes, you should do the ukara desha. And in all other cases where the purva pada is saha or eshaha, always delete the visarga regardless. Don't even think what the para is. Once you have understood that the para is not the hrasva akara, and you come to know that the purva pada is saha or eshaha, just delete the visarga. And one more word of caution. If this visarga follows something, only you have to delete it. So see, this rule says that the parakshara can be anything. It does not say the parakshara is nothing. Now this seems riddle. What does that mean? That means if the eshaha or saha occurs at the end of a sentence, for example, this eshaha khidyate is not, now this eshaha has not come at the end of a sentence. If the eshaha came at the end of a sentence like khidyate eshaha, okay, if this reversed, it becomes khidyate plus eshaha, then should you do the sandhi? Should you delete the visarga regardless? No. See, these sandhis occur always when there are two varnas joining. At the end of a sentence, is there any other varna besides the visarga in the para position? No, there is just the full stop. It is not a varna, okay? So you can't do the sandhi there. You should always remember that. So in the cases where the saha or eshaha is followed by a, hrasva a, do the ukara desha. In all other cases where it is followed by anything else, you delete the visarga. Some examples and then we shall wind up. Sarvashaha plus eva. Now this is the hrasva. Now after this discussion about saha and eshaha, clear your mind now. Come back to the rules of the scenarios. You have the upadha being a, para is a. So you have the any other swara but the hrasva akara. Okay. This is the upadha is a. Scenario two. See, upadha is a. Anything else but the hrasva akara. In this case, it is a. Do the lopa. So it becomes sarvasha eva. Sarvasha eva. Okay. Similarly, bala eshaha. How do you split this bala eshaha? The reverse of it. See, you see this gap here. This means visarga was present here. So balaha eshaha. This is simpler. Balaha eshaha. Now balaha yung aramati. Aramati. Again, the para is a swara. Okay. What type of swara is it? Is it the hrasva akara? No, it is the dirgha akara. So it is not an exception. So you go according to the second scenario's rule, which is delete the visarga. So bala aramati. What was the second? Now it is recommended that you write down these rules in a separate notebook so that you can refer it as you're solving the examples and the exercises. So you see here the upadha is a. In balaha, balaha, aha, a is the upadha. Any other swara is there, which is aramati. So bala aramati. Don't do any more sandhis. Janaha helanti. First scenario. Mrudu vyanjana. First case, first scenario of lopa. Mridu vyanjana, upadha, then deleted. Jana, helanti. One last time I'll show you. First scenario, the para is amridu vyanjana, so then deleted. No confusion here. Kutaha ipsase, upadha hraswa a, any other swara, so deleted. Kuta ipsase. Any other swara meaning? Any other swara but the hraswa a here also. Then anganaha mahilaha. Ah, once a comes and you have any other mridu vyanjana or a swara, don't even think second thoughts. You don't have any second thoughts. Just delete it. Angana mahilaha. Malayaha alasyam. Again, a is there. You see the para is the first case, meaning it is either a swara or a mridu vyanjana, deleted. Malaya alasyam. Okay. Next class will be Rephadesha. So practice this well and we shall see you in the next class. Dhanyavadaha.